Hello and welcome back to another MLB The Show 18 video with Sports Gamers Online. I am Casual Gamer and a link to my channel will be below in the description. Today we're going to talk about how to tackle this Conquest Extreme as it is giving lots of people, including myself, fits just trying to get it done. First, let's talk about how to take the Cub Stronghold in one turn. All you're going to do is you get these five guys, you're just going to go over here, and then very simple, you're just going to attack them and you have to just win on the first attempt, and if you don't, just restart, do it again. So very simple for taking the Cub Stronghold, you'll just have to win a game on Hall of Fame difficulty, which can be very difficult, and you'll just have to keep restarting until you can get that win. Next, you have to conquer the Rockies on or before turn 2. Again, same strategy as before, you just go right up here. That could have simmed out just there and made me lose my people and I would have had to restart, but fortunately I was very lucky and I did not lose my people, so I would be able to attack the Rockies and have to beat them again on Hall of Fame difficulty. The next one you have to do is you have to conquer the Dodgers on or before turn 2. For this one, you want to make like a diagonal line coming down this way, and you're going to stop it when you get here because you're right in line with the Dodgers now, right? And this avoids, if you get too close up here, you can get too close to the Rockies and they'll attack you. So you want to stay in this exact line right here and then come here. And then during the Steel Fans phase, you will have to select the Dodgers and play them on Legend difficulty so that you can steal 5 million fans from their fan base, which will weaken them a little bit. But more importantly, it will get you all the way up here. So next turn you will get 2 because you have 6 territories and you get 1 reinforcement every turn for every 3 territories. So you have 6, so you'll get 2 plus the 5, so that's 7 plus the one that's already here, so that is 8. And then you will go 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. You have to play this game, it will be on veteran, and then you will have to attack the Dodgers, I believe, on legend difficulty. Next up is the Rangers on or before turn 2. So what you're going to do for this is come down here and avoid, you just want to avoid like the circles around, because that's what all the teams do, is they circle around their base like you see them doing. So you just want to avoid the Kansas City circle. And then in the Steal Fans phase, you could steal on Legend difficulty again, but I do believe that you only need to steal on All-Star, because that'll get you 3 plus the one you have there, that's 4 plus the 2 you get, so that's 6, so that's 5, 4. Yeah, I mean, you could even do it on probably Veteran if you wanted to, but I would suggest All-Star or higher so that you make sure you have enough attempts to get the Rangers Stronghold. Next up is to conquer the Yankees Stronghold on or before turn 2. This one tripped me up a little bit because I wasn't thinking about like what direction I needed to go originally, so I messed this one up when I was first playing it. So as you see, the Brewers have 2 reinforcements right in front of you, so what you want to do is go here and you're gonna hit simulate. Now, 19 out of 20 times you will lose, as you just saw me do there, but you haven't really lost anything because you didn't have to play any games when you simulated. So now all you're going to do is just restart until you can get a good sim and get to take that space. So I just did this sim about 20 times, maybe more. It was incredibly frustrating to get this sim, so it may be easier to just go ahead and play the game, but when I did it originally and I conquered the Yankees, it was much easier to sim. So what I would do here, since the Yankees have so many fans, they always start with way more than anyone else, and the Tigers start with 10. So if you take 5 away from the 15 at the Yankees, it's really not going to impact that much the difficulty you have to play them on. So I would play the Tigers on Legend here. You steal 5 fans from them if you play on Legend. So then you will receive the 5 plus your 2 reinforcements, so you'll have 8 people here total. You have 7, and then you want to play this game because I've had some crappy sims that have destroyed all of my reinforcements. So you want to play this game on Rookie, and then you will play this game, I believe, on All-Star if you played on Legend before. Then you want to hope that this space stays open, because then you get a free pass. If not, you just need to play another game pretty much on Rookie and keep moving towards the Yankees. You need to go in this straight line to take the Yankees, because if you go around, you actually will not get enough reinforcements to be able to attack the Yankees. That's how I tried to do it the first time without counting it out, and I did not make it. So you absolutely have to go through here. Also, sometimes the Brewers try and break up your line of people here, so you can add reinforcements from anyone connected to your new stronghold, which used to be the Tiger stronghold. Then you will have to play on either Hall of Fame or Legend difficulty, I believe, to beat the Yankees, but then you will have conquered the Yankees. Next up is conquering the Brewers stronghold on or before turn two. So this one, I believe, was pretty simple. You just go around here, and then unlike the Yankees one where you're going to sim this game right here that's about to come up with a two, there's no real reason to do that. So you're just going to come here and simulate this one, which gives you much better odds, although I still lost there. So that time it only took two attempts to get the sim in. So on this turn, you have a couple options. If you believe that you can beat the Brewers in one game on Legend or on Hall of Fame, then you can just skip this Steel Fans phase and skip to Reinforce. And then you could reinforce right here and attack. And yeah, so it would be on Hall of Fame if you don't want to steal any fans. Now, if you do steal fans, that will decrease the number they have and give you more, which giving you the advantage in the difficulty. Here, you just need to win that one game against the Stronghold, or the one game against the Stronghold and the Steel Fans game in order to conquer the Brewer's Stronghold. Next up is conquering the Red Stronghold on or before turn three. This is where it begins to get a little trickier, but not too much. You're going to come down here, and again, avoiding the circles around people's strongholds, just because they will attack you if you're occupying the spaces they want to occupy. So you're going to come down this diagonal line, and then next turn you will steal some fans from the Reds and get your reinforcements. I think you might want to do Legend just to make sure you have enough people, and get down to here, and then you just come straight across in a line and attack there. If there are any games with one person in the way, I would suggest just playing them, as I've said before, so that you don't lose your reinforcements after having just won on an incredibly hard difficulty. Next is conquering the Diamondbacks stronghold on or before turn three. Here you're going to come down similar to how you did against the Dodgers and just keep working your way down until you are level with them. So you'll play the steal fans thing and steal five, or you could steal four or three. They don't have that many, so you don't need to do legend if you don't want to, since you have another turn. So if you steal like three, for instance, and you get your two reinforcements, that's five, six, so five, four, three, two. So you would have like one shot on turn two and then another shot on turn three. Next is conquering the Marlins on or before turn three. Now this is where things really start to get interesting. So with the Marlins, you're gonna have to come down similar to the Reds and go down here. So on the first turn, I would actually steal fans from the Rays, because you will have to steal fans from two teams in order to have enough people to make it all the way down to the Marlins. You will have to play the steal fans games on Legend to be able to make it all the way there. So once you get the five fans from the Rays and the two from your reinforcements, you will have eight fans here, so that'll be 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And you'll get three or four just from the territories you have occupied. So let's say you get three plus your five plus the one, that's nine. So 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3 reinforcements to attack one. So you'll probably have to just play this on veteran. The next one you gotta go for is the Giant Stronghold on or before turn three. So here there is a straight shot, as you can see, right to the Giants, but as you guys have heard me say a couple times, you want to avoid the rings around the strongholds, and there are two in the way, so that is not how you want to get there, because teams will interfere with you. What you want to do is go up here and then over, and then everyone will just leave you alone and completely ignore you. And on the next turn, you will steal some fans from the Giants, so you'll steal five and get your two, so you'll have 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and then I would wait here with your two reinforcements and go to the next turn, steal some more fans from the Giants, and there you go. You can get there and play these games against the computer again, and if there's any here against the computer, make sure you play them, and then you will be able to conquer the Giants' stronghold. In order to conquer the Orioles stronghold on or before turn four, you have to get a little sneaky. You're gonna go here and do the same thing that we did when you were trying to conquer the Yankees. Sim this here, and then you'll play games against the Tigers here and here to take their stronghold and make sure that you can drop off reinforcements closer to where you're going to be. Then you're gonna come down, and this lane actually stays open, or at least it did for me when I did this mission. And you can just take these free spaces right here. This one may not, but these definitely did in this little gap right here. So in your second Steel Fans phase, you will steal from the Orioles, and then you will find the path of least resistance to get to the Orioles. So right now that would be going to here, and then here, and then here, and then attacking the Orioles stronghold. You'll want to steal fans from the Orioles on Legend to make sure that you get five and have enough reinforcements to make it down to them. So just to clarify, on turn two, you'll be starting here and we'll go 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then the next turn, you will get 5 from taking the Orioles fans, and you will get another 3 or 4, so let's say 3 to be conservative. That gives you 9 people here, so 8, 7, 6, and that's an easy win against the Orioles. Next up is conquering the Red Sox on or before turn 4. For this, you're going to do a similar thing to what we were just doing, where you're going to come here and you're going to simulate this game between you and the Brewers and make your way here through the Tigers and up to here. So you will stop here at the end of your first turn and then 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and you'll stop there with 2. So once you steal your 5 fans from the Red Sox and get your 3 fans for the spaces you occupy, you're going to play these games against the computer here and here, and maybe even a couple in here if the computer takes those spaces. So you will be here and go 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, and as you can see, that's plenty of time, as that's only turn 3, and you could stack up even more reinforcements as long as your line is not broken between here and the Tigers. So on turn 3, you could choose to attack them, or you could wait for more reinforcements and attack them on turn 4. Next up, let's talk about conquering the National League Central in 4 or less turns. The teams in the NL Central are the Brewers, the Cubs, the Cardinals, the Reds, and the Pirates. So the best way to do this is to go up here and you're gonna sim this game 2-1 against the Brewers right here, and then on the next turn you'll steal fans from the Brewers, since that's who you're about to have to play. So you want to play on Legends so that you get 5 people, and then you get your additional 2, so you'll have 8 right here, and then you go 7, 6, 5, making your way down to the Cubs, 4, and then you could attack them here, which is what I would do. Attack them, so that's 3, 2, 1, and look at that. You've already taken the Brewers and the Cubs on turn 2, and you're making your way towards the Cardinals. So on this next turn, you will be getting 3 or 4 reinforcements from the space you occupy, and you'll be stealing 5 fans from the Cardinals here. 9 people that you will have here at least, so that would be 8, 7, 6. You will need to play them here, 7, and then 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. So this is on our third turn now, and then I would wait, and you'll get more reinforcements. So you steal another 5 is what I would do, and then you can attack the Reds, and obviously with the like 10 plus reinforcements that you'll have here, you will have plenty to get from the Reds to the Pirates in turn 4. Next up is conquering the AL West on or before turn 6. The teams in the AL West are the A's, the Mariners, the Astros, the Rangers over here, and the Angels over here. So this is very spread out, but you do have 6 turns to get it done. So what I would suggest doing is another, you remember how we looped over here and then down around, and see how it's like one continuous flow kind of, it's the same thing you want to do with the 6 turn one. So you're going to go up until you're on a straight line with Seattle, and then you're going to go over to Seattle. At the end of turn 1, you will steal fans from the Mariners. You want to steal 5, and you'll get your 2 from the territories you occupy, so you'll have 8 here, so that's 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and then you could attack them, but I would just wait a turn. You could even wait here a turn so that you're not right next to their stronghold where they can attack you, and then you will be getting about 3 or 4 reinforcements plus the 5 in the next steal fans phase. You will get another 5, which I would steal from the A's, since that's where you're going to have to go next. So you'll have about 9 people here, so that's 8, 7, and then you're going to go 6, 5, 4. I would suggest to just attack the A stronghold here, so that's 3, 2, and then you end up here with 1. So at the end of turn 3, you will steal some fans from the Angels, and then you will attack them, and you will have about 10 or 11 at this point. So that would be 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. At the end of turn 4, you will steal from either the Rangers or from the Astros, either one you choose. So you will have your 5, you'll have around like 10 again, let's say. So that's 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. You can attack them here. At the end of turn 5, you can steal from the Astros. And you see you have absolutely plenty because you have about 10 again, and that's 9, 8, 7. And so you will have absolutely plenty of people to take down the Astros, and that is how you complete the AL West in 6 turns or less. To get from 70% to 100% in Conquest Extreme, you will have to conquer all of the strongholds in 18 turns or less, 15 turns or less, and then 12 turns or less. So the best strategy to me, first off, is to try to complete this in 12 turns or less, because then that unlocks all of the other ones. So the 18 and the 15, you can pretty much just throw away. So ordinarily the strategy for beating Conquest is to go up towards the Mariners, but because there is a time restriction, you are going to want to go towards the Rockies. And as you can see there, I just got a very lucky sim. That's what you want, so that you can attack the Rockies right away and then work your way up toward the Mariners. You need to win all of the games that you're playing. So assuming that you win this game here, that's 2-1, and you'll get about 8 people. So 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So that's the end of turn 2 right there, and you'll steal some more fans. You know, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. And look at that, you already have 4 strongholds, and we're just at the end of turn 3. So again, let's say you have 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So then we'll get another 11, let's say. So 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And that is the end of turn 5. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And that is the end of turn 6. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And that is the end of turn 7. And remember, I'm giving us that many reinforcements. You may be getting more reinforcements than that, but that's like the minimum, just to show you guys that it can be done. And I'm assuming that you will be playing all of these Steel Fan games on Legend and winning. So that is something that will be very difficult, but that is why it is called Conquest Extreme. 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and that is the end of turn 9. Now I'm going to start giving us a few more reinforcements because I've been very limited with the number I'm giving us. You will most definitely be getting more. I was just trying to be very conservative. So let's start with like 15. So like 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's the end of turn 10. And then turn 11, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8. And there you go. That's the last stronghold. And that is how you do it in 12 turns or less. So once you complete this Conquest Extreme in 12 turns or less, it will unlock the other two objectives, the 15 turns and 18 turns, and you will unlock the two best cards available through Solo Challenge rewards. I am, of course, talking about 93 Yadier Molina and 92 Matt Kemp. As you guys can see the stats on the screen, they speak for themselves. These are two excellent cards, absolutely outstanding. Everyone should be wanting these cards. Everyone should be grinding as much as they possibly can to get these cards because they are absolutely free and a key factor on any of your teams. Yadier Molina's defense and blocking really makes him stand out, while Matt Kemp is a very balanced player hitting in the field and running. If you enjoyed this and would like to see more, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and hit that notification bell. Thank you guys for watching. Peace.